You can't continue to cash finance the defense of the United States and not end up in the blind alley we're in right now, so that it becomes a war of each against all. War of each service against all the other services, the jointness disappears, and a war of programs against each other, and a war of each dollar against the other dollar, because it is not separated between a capital asset acquisition and an operating necessity.
Sir, what does breathing room mean in terms of future combat systems?
That's a good question. It's a work in progress.
Of the $19 billion the Air Force is asking for in unfunded assets, how much of this is going to actually get approved?
I have no clue, because we're taking that up in the same context that I just mentioned. Namely, that's something else that gets dumped in.
Are the priorities going to be F-22 and C-17?
We'll see.
You've talked about capital budgeting for a long time. What makes this different? Are you planning anything legislatively?
Events are catching up with us. And I've said that before. I said, either we get a hold of this and get ahead of the game, or events are going to get in the saddle and ride us. And events are now getting in the saddle, and they're beginning to ride everybody.
So what does that mean in terms of what Congress will do?
I wish the Congress would be more proactive on this, but I can't find much in the way of sentiment for that. We're pretty much moving on the same way, cash financing our way along, and choosing whose throat will be cut. And I think it's going to have to come from the executive side when the Pentagon says to us, we can't do this anymore. And so they're going to be forced to come up with any one of several plans or proposals with regard to capital budgeting. I've had those conversations with the highest levels of the Pentagon. Mm-hmm. And I think that the next administration is probably going to have to come forward with some kind of a capital budgeting proposal.